my screen here, and you know, I do. I believe now is the time, and the reason being is that we've been through this before, and we've seen some things, and so just to give a little foundation on what where we're at, what's going on, I just wanted to kind of set some a stage here. So you know, and the company started in 2005, you know, December of 2005, and we were rocking around, and I know just for myself. We went IMD in the first year, about 12 months and 10 days, roughly, or so. And there were other people, you guys included, that were building big businesses during that first time, that first surge, and we had it going. But here's what happened in 2007, 2009 era, that recession that we talk about, the Great Recession here. And if you, you know, if you look at it, just to look at that chart over to the right, let me show you something. So this is what was going along the U.S. economic growth back in that time. And so World Ventures starts right there. And if you look at that part in the graph, most people would say that's probably not the optimal time to start a new company. It's not an optimal time for me to get involved with something. But that's where we jumped into World Ventures. And here's what's interesting. You know, we went around, we went along, and for, again, for myself, IMD in 12 months. But that's not where the real growth happened. The real growth happened in this area, that blue area that I'm showing right there. And if you look at that, that's 2007, 2009. And for the three of us on the phone that were building the business, this is where we got rich. And not only us, if you look at guys like names that you guys know right now, Jefferson Santos of the world, Carrie and Leisha Snyder, these type of people, David Avetuloa, people that were here that put their head down and didn't listen to the rhetoric that was going on, because I can remember back in 2007, 2009, people saying, man, it's horrible out there. You know, just hold on. And we weren't holding on. We had our head down going, and this is when we got rich. Now, why am I saying that? Because it's a parallel time right now. See, the coronavirus and the, you know, danger's real. Yeah, coronavirus is real, but fear is a choice. And so we get to choose how we react to what's going on. And the world around us, the masses around us, most of them are reacting in fear. They're like, they don't know what to do. And here's why, because the news and everything around them, look at this, 37 million jobs will be lost. This is what they're estimating. People are panicked. People don't know what to do. Right here in the U.S., and I know we got people from around the world on this, but right here in the U.S., 3.3 million Americans have already filed for unemployment. The largest amount of people at any one time to file for unemployment. It's happening right now. Fear is a choice. And so, but the masses react in fear when champions adjust. So I want to talk to you about what champions do. Here's a champion right here. Probably the greatest investor of our time. His name is Warren Buffett. And people are wondering, why, you know, why now? Why travel now? Because nobody's traveling. That's what the masses are saying. But Warren Buffett, the greatest investor of our time, says, I'm doubling down. I'm going to go invest in the travel industry hard right now, because he knows what's getting ready to happen coming out of here. Because just like you guys right now, we're all cooped up in our homes. We can't get out. We can't do. What are most people, the masses of people, going to want to do once this is lifted? Because this too shall pass. This virus is going to go away. It's gonna this whole pandemic will go away. And what are they gonna want to do? You guys know it. They're gonna travel, because travel's an inherent yes. They're gonna want to get to the beach. They're gonna go do some great things. Warren Buffett's betting on it, but most of us don't have $48 million invested in something like that, right? But we do have, you know, a little bit. Look at this right now. Are people really looking for ways to make money? Look at this. This is Google searches of people looking at home-based businesses. So this is the amount of Google searches that are going out. And if you look of a whole year, March of 2019, all the way to where we are now, look what happened when coronavirus hit. Look at the searches that went up for home-based businesses. So when we're saying why now is the time, everything's lining up just like it did in 2007, 2009, but I think in a bigger way, because now we're putting people in their homes. They can't get out. They're chomping at the bit to get out, and we got the cookie. So here's my last slide. Take that slide of 2007, 2009. Change the dates to 2020. Here's where we're at. We're right there at the beginning of this. We don't know how long it's going to last, but here's what I do know. 100% I know that. People are going to get rich right here in this area.
That's exactly
people are going to get rich right there. And so I just wanted to build that foundation, Byron, before we went forward, because I think there's a lot of people that don't understand how big an opportunity we have with, first of all, home-based business, second of all, travel. We are in a great spot right now. So I'm going to stop my share and go back to you guys. So I just wanted to share that.
Troy, in that window, you know,